Hello people, welcome to Gurukula. I am Jay. I am working for RMK College of Engineering and Technology for the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. So in our Communication Networks video lecture series, in our previous video, we might have discussed actually the protocol layering, the actual demand for the protocols that is aligned in a layered fashion. And also we might have discussed about a particular topic called OSI model. In that OSI model, we have discussed the 7 layers of OSI model and then the functionalities of each and every layer that is coming under OSI model. So today in this particular video, we are going to see a little bit deeper into data link layer. And we will also put some light on the various functionalities of data link layer. So today, this particular video and 2 or 3 subsequent videos from now, we will be discussing on the various functions of the data link layer, or I could say the various services of data link layer. So this video is especially focused on introduction to data link layer, and as well as we will see a little bit deeper on what physical addressing is. So physical addressing is one of the layer, one of the functions that is offered by the data link layer. So with this introduction, without any further ado, let us get into the topic. So to start off with the data link layer, we very well know the position of the data link layer on the OSI model. It is a very immediate next layer to physical layer, and then the data link layer will receive informations from the network layer. So your network layer will be an upper layer for your data link layer. So as of now, we might have addressed this particular layer as in one single layer called data link layer, and we have seen what are all the various functions that is offered by data link layer. So now when we are about to discuss data link layer into a little bit deeper, it is very much important to understand that the data link layer is further classified into 2 sub layers, or in other words, I could say that the data link layer has 2 more sub layers. So the first one is logical link control sub layer, that is your LLC sub layer, and then the another sub layer of data link layer is MAC sub layer. So your MAC is nothing but media access control sub layer, and the various functions that is coming under data link layer is being distributed, or it will be taken care by these 2 layers. So your logical link control sublayer acts as an interface between the media access control and then the sublayer, which acts as a network layer. And then the MAC layer is responsible for moving data packets from one network interface card to another network interface card, and the vice versa data reception is also possible. So coming to listing out the functionalities of data link layer, we very well know the various functions carried out by the data link layers are the physical addressing, framing, flow control, error control, and then access control. So here the physical addressing and then the framing will be taken care by the media access control sublayer, and the rest of the functions such as flow control, error control, and access control will be taken care by the logical link control sublayer. And to just to brief about each and every functions of data link layer, first to talk about physical addressing, we very well know what physical addressing is. That is a permanent address for each and every node that is going to be connected on the internet, and we also call physical addressing as MAC address as well. So your physical addressing will be embossed, or it will be burnt on your network interface card itself, which we could not able to change it at any point in time. So next, coming to the framing, the process of adding redundant information to my data so as to send it over the network is what I call it as framing. So next, coming to the flow control, it is actually a controlling mechanism of flow of packets on the network. This you can directly correlate on controlling the traffic on the roads by using signal lights. So that is what we can relate the flow control. And then error control. Coming to the error control, it is a mechanism that is deployed on the network so as to reduce the occurrences of errors. Either we can detect the errors or we can correct the errors. So we will throw some more light on error control as the classes progresses. And coming to the access control, which is nothing but this is controlling the node accessing the channel. So which node should access the channel and when to access the channel. So creating certain protocols for accessing the channel is what we call it as access control. So with this, a brief note on the various functions of data link layer, today this particular video we will be covering in depth on the physical addressing. So to talk about physical addressing is nothing but each and every station on the network has its own network interface card, and that is where you will find your physical address of your particular device. So be it your mobile, be it your laptop, or be it your PC, or be it any device that you are connected on the internet, definitely that will have an physical address, or in other words, we call that as MAC address. So your network interface card provides the 6-byte physical address, and the size of the physical address is of 6 byte. So this is a very broad example of where we can find out the physical address or the MAC address of a particular machine. So next, coming to the representation of physical address, how does it looks like? So my physical address may be represented by using a 6-byte hexadecimal number, or we can also represent that by using a binary representation. And in most of the situations, we will go with a dotted hexadecimal number, which is easy to remember and also it is attractive. So since we will not be using the direct binary representation of the physical addresses. So coming to the classification of addresses, depending upon the type of physical address, we can actually classify what type of address is that. So there are basically 3 types of addresses that is available on the physical addressing. So they are, first one is of unicast. So unicast is nothing but it is defined only one recipient, which means we are going to communicate for only one particular node on the internet. It is almost similar to point-to-point communication or one-on-one communication. So next type of address is multicast address, where here I am trying to talk to a group of recipients in a particular hall. So this is almost similar to one-to-many communication. There may be several participants in a group, but I am interested to talk only to 4 or 5 selective people in that group. So if I wanted to talk to more than one number of people, then I will call that as multicast communication. And on the third method, we have a broadcast, and this is a special case of multicast addressing, where I wanted to talk to everyone that is present in that particular group. So that makes a clear difference between unicast, multicast, and then the broadcast. And the devices that are capable for unicast, that are capable for multicast, that are capable for broadcast will have the respective physical addresses. So just to put in a pictorial representation of the physical addressing, where you can see the A represents the unicast. As you can see, the communication is happening from only one node to another one node. So it is almost similar to the one-on-one communication. And coming to the next type of addressing, we can see that it is a broadcast, and where you can clearly see that the node is trying to communicate from all other nodes present in that particular network. So that is what we call it as a broadcast network. And then coming to the multicast, you can see I am not interacting with all the nodes present in the network, but I am communicating to a selected number of nodes, which is more than one. So here in our situations, or in example, I am trying to communicate with 2 nodes that is present in that particular network. And then there at the bottom, you can clearly see that over here the MAC address have been clearly mentioned. So this is of 6 byte of data represented in hexadecimal format. So for each and every type of addressing, you will have the different MAC addresses over here. So now, given the MAC address, how do we identify whether it belongs to an unicast address or broadcast address or multicast address? So we will see that in a minute. So This is what actually the point which I am talking about. Given an MAC address, how will we identify whether on which type of physical addressing it belongs to? So it all depends upon the last bit of the first byte. So just by observing the last bit of the first byte, you can easily say that the given MAC address belongs to unicast, multicast or a broadcast. So if it is 0, then I can say that the address is an unicast address, and if it is 1, I can say that it is a multicast address, and if it is all 1s, then I can say that it is a broadcast address. So here I can put few examples so as to identify whether the given MAC address is unicast, multicast or broadcast. So this is our very first example, and looking at the very last bit of the first byte, there we have A. So this is an hexadecimal value, and hexadecimal value of A, when I expand it, it will come to 1010. Right, so when I expand it to 1010, then I can clearly see that the last bit of the first byte is ending up with 0. So if it ends with 0, we can say that this particular address is an unicast address. And similarly, taking up the second example, we have 47. So when I expand that hexadecimal value 7 into binary, I'll get 0111. So in that, I can clearly see that the last bit of the first byte ending up in 1. So definitely this particular address belongs to a multicast address. And if it is all 1s, you can see that it is given as all F. The hexadecimal value F represents it is all 1s. So I will say that this is a broadcast address. So usually in our day-to-day communication devices, most of our laptops and then the PC that we use will come with an unicast addresses, because your laptop and then your PC will have an ability to communicate only to your switch or the router where you are connected to the internet. And in special cases, your switches or your routers may have the multicast addresses. Most of the time, your switches will come with an multicast port where they can able to flood the packets to the intended receiver. So the functioning of the switches will be dealt in detail as the course progresses, but as of now it is enough to understand that the PC, the router, all these things will mostly comes with an unicast addresses, and the switches may come as unicast address, or in sometimes it has to multicast, or sometimes it will have to broadcast. So your switches may have unicast address or broadcast addresses. So that's all about this particular video, where we have seen in detail about the physical addressing that is offered by the data link layer. And now we can say that the physical addressing is a function of not the data link layer, but in specific, it is a function of media access layer. So we will see the further functions offered by data link layer in the subsequent videos. I'm going to see you in the next video. Until then, happy learning.